the evening, I saw little Indians away as I come as my usual excursions. The birds that sing sweetly were then going away, most enchantingly nature's exertions. At length in the dusk I espied a young pair, I seldom beheld a beauty so rare. I then felt astonished when I heard them declare, fair maid, will you call me your darling? I waited a moment to hear a reply, disliking of course to disturb them. In the meantime, I wished they had been far away, but I apparently couldn't prevent it. Her blushes and kisses seemed his heart to be quail, and he holding his hand round her neck all the while. Oh, soon you expected, she said with a smile, young man that I'd call you my darling. An abundance of money I'll give you, said he, and in robes I will dress you more splendid. A farm of land and a whole retreat free, and servants in plenty attending. I'll give you a carriage and horses to drive, and a supply of spirits that might serve to deprive her to drown discontent in your heart that might thrive. And fair maid, won't you call me your darling? And if you were to give me all ships in the main, Britannia's powerful dominions, with Persia and Turkey and fertile Lorraine, and also the East and West Indies. Or were you to give me Hibernia of old, or were you to give me largest trunks full of gold, such comical things can my senses blindfold, and for such I'll not call you my darling. I will give you my love, contentment, and ease, though exalted at law be your station. And with much satisfaction I'll try for to please, and to serve you with much consolation. I'll promise to chase from your heart all its woes, and in bed you can lie undisturbed when you chose. In the morning at parting I'll settle the clothes, and fair maid, will you call me your darling? Most lovely and noble and charming to view, her countenance changed in a moment. Her cheeks that were tinged with a little of blue grew red as the tincture of roses. When this damsel at last by those means he did gain, with extended arms he embraced her again. And from laughing I thought I could never refrain when I heard her exclaim, "You're my darling." Confounded I felt, and my heart got amazed, sent deep in a retrograde motion. I stepped through the bushes, not knowing when to range, like a ship in the midst of the ocean. Ever since when I would cast a glance at the same, my heart went transported to praises again, and soon it disperses all trouble and pain, when I think of the lover and darling.